If you're a white Southerner, you know exactly what it means, don't you? What it means is, I give you the economy you had 50 years ago, and I'll move you back up on the social totem pole and other people down.
Well, Bill Clinton would know about that because, well, he's used that language before. Watch this.
Now you are being called upon, every one of you, to secure a better future for your children and your grandchildren and to make America great again.
I want to attack these problems and make America great again.
I believe that together we can make America great again.
Our nightly political panel joins us now. The Weekly Standard's John McCormick and Fortune. Anyway, legitimate to say that Donald Trump's slogan, Make America Great Again, is a racial message?
I thought it was a pretty dopey move by Bill Clinton. I mean, Make America Great Again is commonly used by politicians. Well, Ronald Reagan ran on Make America Great and, you know, Morning Again in America. Right. It's very common. And Bill Clinton should have said something like, oh, he's going to make him great by using a role model of Vladimir Putin. That would have been more effective. Right. And if you're going to play the race card, there are other issues to use with Donald.
I mean, it's something that people running for office say when their party is out of power. Reagan did it when the Republicans were out of power. The Clintons did it when the Democrats were out of power. So it's really bizarre. I mean, if you're going to attack Trump, there's no shortage of terrible things that he has said or done. Clinton is either slipping or he's panicking.
You know, this question of his slipping has been raised before. I've covered him in the White House. I've known him for a long time. And, you know, they don't call him the big dog for nothing. I mean, he's been a tremendous political talent. At times in recent years, he seemed a little frail. You know, he hasn't been totally well. I thought at the convention when he spoke, he was his old self. But does this suggest to you, as it does to John and Nina, that he's slipping?
Well, I don't know if he's slipping. He's spotty. I mean, sometimes he's great, as you pointed out. But keep in mind, remember back in 2008, he was not always a good asset for Hillary Clinton. He got her in trouble on racial issues during that campaign. So I think he's spotty. He's a naturally good politician, but yeah, he's not always on his game.
So what's the right play here, John? Is it the right play to say, we love you, Mr. Clinton, we love you, Mr. President, but would you go sit over there for a while and not say anything?
I mean, you'd hate to take Clinton completely out of the game because he really is one of the savviest and most effective communicators. I think we all remember back in 2012 when he
smile more, but some people are not happy with that because they say such things are sexist. The controversy reemerged this week when RNC Chairman Reince Priebus criticized Hillary Clinton's performance at a primetime presidential forum. He tweeted, quote, Hillary Clinton was angry and defensive the entire time, no smile and uncomfortable, upset that she was caught wrongly sending our secret. In response, Ms. Clinton tweeted,
In that particular half hour, and she had a reason to be irritated.
I don't take my advice and I don't take anything seriously that comes from the RNC.
She got defensive?
About his deep admiration and support for Vladimir Putin.
Fox and Friends Weekend, my buddy Tucker Carlson joins us. Now, hiya, Tucker. What do you make of this?
Hey, Brett. I think it's weird. I mean, look, she's actually acting against her own interests here. She sent out a whole ton of surrogates to accuse Trump and the RNC of sexism. If you think about it for a minute, that doesn't serve her interests. Hillary Clinton's main strength is that she is strong. She spent 35 years on the public stage. She's been embroiled in a lot of scandals, and she's still standing. And that's something I think even her detractors can admire, something I admire, actually. She has a toughness. And yet when she calls foul on sexism, when she says they're being mean to me because I'm a woman, or when she, as she did the other day, recalls some insult that she heard 50 years ago and concedes that it still wounds her, she comes off as brittle. And I don't think that helps her case at all.
You know, at the Democratic convention, and she has it other times on the campaign to be kind of angry and joyless and, yes, unsmiling. I said that on the air, and I really caught it on Twitter from people who said, you know, you're just a sexist. I can't believe somebody's saying that. But it raises this question, Tucker. In America today, is it possible for a woman to be shrill? And if so, or joyless, or unsmiling, is it possible for somebody to say that without ending up under the jail?
Well, probably not, but I mean, I think the best course is to ignore it because the accusation is prima facie ludicrous. This is the most powerful woman on the face of planet Earth. This is someone who is worth $250 million. The idea that she's put upon because of her sex is insane. If she's a victim of bias, then who isn't? But again, Hillary Clinton is winning when she seems stern and in control. I think this, you know, her attempts to play, you know, a human being have been ham-handed and failed. People are really afraid about the course of the country. And I think if you seem like the sober leader, you win. And so, you know, sort of be yourself and stop whining. Whining never makes you look strong. It makes you look weak.
Well, what about this overall issue about her being unhappy? And do you think the stern Hillary is a winner, or do you think that the softer Hillary, even tonight in her remarks after meeting with her national security advisors, she was quite subdued and soft-spoken?
Right.
It looked like it might be conscious to me. What's your take on what works best for her?
Well, look, I mean, there's no doubt that Hillary Clinton is a human being. She has the same staff for 20 years, and they clearly like her. They haven't left. So there is a warm side to her. It's not often on display. I don't think it needs to be. Look, if you're voting for Hillary, you probably are doing so by default. I don't think many people want to vote for Hillary Clinton, but they're afraid of Donald Trump. They know we're at a pivot point in American history, and they want someone who is predictable. And so I think it kind of helps her to say, look, I'm a serious person hoping to take a serious job. And any attempt at falseness, and she has many of them, they fall flat. They're laughable. They're phony. And you saw it, I don't want to be too mean, but you saw it in a couple of the speeches on the floor of the convention in Philadelphia, this attempt to humanize her. Boy, if she's not human after 30 years in the public lens, probably too late to pull that off, I would think.
Tucker, thank you.
Thank you, Brett.
The ballot? Yeah, I'd like to have you back, buddy. Hope to see you soon. They're in the mail in North Carolina. It's 59 days until Election Day, but absentee voting by mail began today in the Tar Heel State, which remains a total toss-up. The two latest polls out of North Carolina tell two different stories. The Quinnipiac poll of North Carolina voters has Hillary Clinton leading by 4 points, but a Suffolk poll of North Carolina voters has Donald Trump leading by 3. Fox News' Peter Ducey is in Raleigh, North Carolina tonight. Peter, what are you seeing down there, buddy?
2008, when Barack Obama did probably the biggest thing we'll ever see in North Carolina, he still barely won the election.
17 days of in-person early voting, and those 17 days have been a source of great controversy in the Tar Heel State because Republicans tried to limit the hours at some locations, leading the New York Times of such a long early voting period and the higher probability this way, they think, of voter fraud. Plus, if people start voting now, they can't change their minds before November.
I think there are some dangers, I think, in an extremely long early vote.